So, a couple days ago, I went on a trip down memory lane. For some reason, I decided to look at, you know, my history on YouTube and my video catalog. And I stumbled across these two videos from my early YouTube career. And my god, was I off. Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Hey yo, why the hell did I say it like that? Yo, what?
Looking back at it now, you know, I kind of take it back. He kind of did live up to the expectations.
All right, yo. I'm done exposing myself. Holy.
But hey, that's why they're called predictions. And I was also like 15 at the time. Not to say that 19 is old and ancient or anything, but I've learned a lot since then about basketball. And I would also say that my voice has gotten deeper, which, you know, I really want to remake that video. And since it is the start of a new decade, and it's been 3 years, I think it's the perfect time to do it. So let's talk about 6 players in the NBA that I believe in the future will become NBA superstars. But before we get into the rest of the video, let's go ahead and shout out the sponsors of this video, SeatGeek. SeatGeek is an app that gets tickets from all over the web. It puts them on one app so you can get the best deals for whatever event you want to go to, whether it be an NBA game, whether you want to go to a Travis Scott concert or a Billie Eilish concert, wherever you want to go, SeatGeek has you covered. They give you a map of the events you want to go to, and it's color-coded. The best deals marked with a green dot, the worst ones marked with red. They have very useful filters, specifically one that shows prices with ticket fees included, which I think is highly underrated. And thanks to SeatGeek, you guys can use the code BSOLS to get $20 off your first purchase. Links will be in the description. And again, shout out to SeatGeek for sponsoring this video. But now that we got that out the way, let's go ahead and get into the rest of this video. Luka Doncic. Luka Doncic may already be a superstar, only in the second year in the league. At the age of 20, Luka Doncic is averaging 29 points, 9 assists, 10 rebounds on 47-33, 80 splits. I mean, do I even need to say more? Even with increased spacing and increased pace in today's NBA, I would still say that his numbers are comparable to LeBron so far. And mind you, the guy is only 20 years old. And I truly think he is the model for what the future NBA is heading in, specifically in the guard position. If you guys haven't watched this video on the screen, please go ahead and watch it. But in this video, I talk about how in the future, 6'7", 6'8", shot creating ball handlers will be what's preferred from the point guard position. And I believe Luka Doncic represents exactly what that is. And the fact that he's so ahead of the curve is why he'll be a future NBA superstar. Trae Young. Next up, let's talk about the guy that was also in Luka Doncic's draft, Trae Young. Despite not nearly having as many wins as Luka, Trae Young has had a historical sophomore year as well. In the second year in the league, Trae Young is putting up 29 points, 8 assists, 5 rebounds on 44-37 and 85 splits. Those numbers are phenomenal and historical themselves. The only reason they're even being overshadowed is because of Luka Doncic and the craziness he's doing this season. I mean, the guy's only 21 years old. In his second year, putting up 29 points. I understand some players need time. When you look at guys like Brandon Ingram and Jaylen Brown, and when you look at guys like Lonzo, who a lot of people are saying, just give him more time. But then you look at guys like Luka and Trae Young and the other guys I'll mention on this list, you can't blame other people or some people in the NBA community for asking good to great production from these young players, because it's been done before. And there are players in the league doing it right now who've had comparable hype to those players. And Trae Young is a player that came into the league with a lot of hype and is delivering on that hype. If someone deserves the next Steph Curry moniker, I would give it to Trae Young. From his play style to his stats, I would give it to Trae Young. Zion Williamson. Now, Zion Williamson has had a rocky start to his rookie season, but I'm still on that hype train. Never have I seen this combination of athleticism, power, strength, agility, which I guess is all athleticism, but also his skill. As for his build, Zion is a very smart player, and I would say has ball handling skills that you wouldn't expect from a player of his size. And I think Zion has the physical gifts to develop into one of the best defenders in the league and be unstoppable on the offensive end. Now, he's not gonna hit you with a bunch of moves like James Harden or Trae Young or Luka, but he's definitely going to be one of those power players. Not that I'm comparing him to Giannis, and not that I feel like he's going to score like Giannis does, but I feel like it definitely will be in that lane of bully ball and using your physical gifts to your advantage. And harkening back on the defensive end, Zion is what, 6'6", 6'7", with one of the best leaping abilities we've ever seen, is quick on his feet. This is a guy that can be one of the most versatile defenders we've ever seen. And I'm very excited to see what Zion can bring to the game of basketball moving forward. I truly think that he is a generational talent. Donovan Mitchell. To me, Donovan Mitchell is one of the most underappreciated stars in today's league. The man has been the number one option on a perennial 50-win Jazz team since his rookie year, and he's only been in the league for 3 years. That is a lot to ask for from a young player, and he has delivered. Not to mention the fact that no one expected Donovan Mitchell to do that, yet he's done it. Donovan Mitchell this season is averaging 24 points, 4 assists and 4 rebounds on 46, 36, 84 splits. Those splits are great. I said a couple months ago that if Donovan Mitchell can keep the amount of points per game he's been averaging, but increase his efficiency, that'll go a long way with the Utah Jazz. And it definitely has, as of the making of this video, the Jazz are 27-12 and have the third best record in the Western Conference and are currently on a 9-game winning streak. I know D. Mitch can seem like a shot chucker from time to time, but once again, he's only 23 years old and he's already accomplished a decent amount in his young career. Jason Tatum. The Tatum hype train has kind of died down since 2018 when he reached the Eastern Conference Finals without Kyrie, but man, the man is still talented. Oh my goodness, Jason Tatum is talented. While efficiency could be better, he's taken a leap in volume and has really taken that mantle as Boston's future cornerstone. Like Donovan Mitchell, Jason Tatum is also in his third year, is 21 turning 22 years old, and this season he's averaging 21 points, 7 rebounds and 3 assists on 43, 36, 86 splits. Now like I said, efficiency could be better, but the fact that he's taken charge of this team has been really huge. But what most people haven't really recognized about Jason Tatum this year is his improvement on the defensive end. Coming into the league, a lot of people doubted his defensive ability. Looking at Jason Tatum, he looked a little bit too lanky, looked a little bit too skinny to be effective on the defensive end. But just in his third year in the league, he has developed into a very solid defender. Being 6'8", 6'9", with his wingspan and his agility on the defensive end, he's a very versatile defender. And he's been great for the Celtics defensively as they've been playing him at the power forward this year. Jason Tatum coming into the league was one of the most polished offensive players I've ever seen in terms of skill. Coming into the league, he already had a bag of tricks. And I believe moving forward, Jason Tatum can only build from that. And in his prime, I think Jason Tatum is a player capable of leading the Celtics to a 55-56 win season, averaging 26-27 points a game, 8 rebounds, 4 assists, on really good efficiency. I believe that's how good Jason Tatum is, if not better. And like I said, while many people are off that hype train, I'm still on. And my next and last pick for this video is more of a bold prediction on my part. I believe Ja Morant will be a future NBA superstar. Now, I'm not gonna say I've been a fan since like high school, but I've definitely been on that train since college, and I was a big fan of him going into the draft last year. While his rookie year hasn't been anything historic, or at least to the naked eye, I mean, the guy's averaging 18.7 assists on good efficiency. That's nothing really eye-popping. He's definitely shown star potential and has that build to be a franchise cornerstone. He's very athletic, he's a decent shooter, and has a great feel for the game. And actually, as of the making of this video, the Memphis Grizzlies are the 8th seed in the Western Conference, and this is just in his rookie year. Again, I don't have the numbers to back up my superstar claim, but this is more of a gut feeling pick, and I believe Ja Morant going into the future is going to be a monster, especially if he develops alongside Jaren Jackson, who I believe is also a future star but not a superstar, which is why I didn't include him in this video. Now, B-Souls, why didn't you mention Nikola Jokic or Giannis or Kat or Devin Booker? Now, those players do have the potential to be superstars, but the reason I didn't include them in this video is for one of two reasons. Number one, they are probably already considered superstars. Giannis has already made the Eastern Conference Finals, has an MVP to his name, and has been in the league for 7 years. Nikola Jokic has been in the league for already 5 years, has already been an All-Star, has been on an All-NBA team, led the Nuggets to the second best record in the West last year, is doing it again this season so far. I mean, these are players that I personally would have included when I made those videos that I talked about in the beginning of this video. Now, honorable mentions I would like to mention in this video are Brandon Ingram, Ben Simmons, Jaylen Brown, and Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. These are players that I believe will be stars in the future and will be great players, but I don't believe deserve that moniker of being a superstar. But with that being said, that's going to be it for this video. Leave a like on this video if you liked it. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Let me know what y'all think about my predictions. I know a lot of people will have a problem with it because this is more of a opinionated video and a predictions video, but let me know in the comment section. Was I wrong for putting Donovan Mitchell in there but not Ben Simmons? Was I wrong for putting in Jason Tatum but not Jaylen Brown? Let me know in the comment section. But with that being said, I'm out. Peace.